Look at these guys. My viewer found them in her apartment and decided to ask me who they are. Note the characteristic pattern on their bodies. And now look at the photo of the red mite Dermanyssus gallinae from Wiki. It's hard not to agree that they are quite similar. I cannot say with absolute certainty that this girl has exactly red mites in her home, but it is almost certainly mites of the genus Dermanyssus. Members of this genus mostly parasitize on birds and near the houses are most often found either in birds' nests or in henhouses, dovecotes, and so on. Many species of this genus have a similar pattern of viscera on their bodies, call it idiosome. And to distinguish them, you need to look at the legs, idiosoma, and other organs under the microscope. Here, for example, is the swallow mite Dermanyssus hirundinis. And here is a sparrow mite Dermanyssus passerinus. They are quite similar. But to be honest, identifying them exactly to the species is not necessary really for successful extermination of them. It is enough to understand that those are bird mites, to understand what to do if you miss such friends at home. We see that these are the bird mites and highly likely are the red mites, parasites of poultry and other birds. Almost everything that I said in the video about red mites and their relationship with humans is true for red mites as well. Red mites can also bite humans if for some reason their normal hosts are not available to them. Their bites are also painful and itch for a long time, and they bite mostly at night when people are sleeping. And in one blood sucking, each mite can suck 10 times more blood than it weighs itself. Yeah, such a typical trait for blood sucking mites. The most important difference between red mites and red mites, right, is that red mites parasitize mostly on rodents and therefore breed mostly in nests of rats and mice in basements, while red mites parasitize on birds and breed in and near birds' nests in attics. And consequently, red mites tend to bother people on the first floors, and red mites, as a rule, bite people on the highest floors. This is not a fundamental truth, because rats can also live in attics and with their offspring feed mites here. And birds can nest on the windows on the first floors and under the eaves, and here on the first floors bird mites can appear. In private houses, the habitat zones of the species merge. Here both the red mites from the basements and red mites from the attic or from the hen house can enter all living premises. The girl who sent these photos wrote that she lives on the fifth floor of a five-story house, right under the attic, and all doubts were immediately dispelled. Yes, most likely at a distance of one slab from her room, pigeons, swifts, and sparrows raise chicks, and these mites are teeming in their nests. But when the chicks leave the nest, or in the spring, when these mites become active after a cold winter, they begin to look for at least someone or for something to get a portion of blood. We find ways to crawl into the apartment, and here they bite people. Important point. Look at pictures of these mites on a real scale. This is so that you don't think that you can easily see with the naked eye that these mites have some kind of pattern, and do not expect to easily compare them with just gray red mites that don't have such a pattern. Here, by the way, is a video of these gamasid mites from another viewer. I guess you have already realized that to see differences between mite species, to recognize this pattern on the mite's body, you have to look straight up good, or look at them through a microscope, or take a macro photo, as the author of these pictures did, for example, because the body length of this parasite is less than 1 millimeter, and not everyone can see them at all, let alone looking at their viscera through body integuments. But frankly speaking, I confess that it is more of a research interest to distinguish species and to determine which genus the mite from a particular photo belongs to. There is no practical point in such precise identification when dealing with gamasid mites at home, because bird mites can live almost anywhere in and on and near the house, and many species of the genus Ornithonyssus, to which red mites belong, also parasitize on birds. For example, it is impossible to distinguish the red mite Ornithonyssus bacoti from the northern bird mite Ornithonyssus sylviarum in such a photo or even with the naked eye, although they parasitize on different hosts and their sources in the house should be sought in completely different places. So it is not possible to determine the species of mites from a photo so accurately that you know for sure which place in the house they come from. Indeed, it is important just to be able to identify that those are gamasid mites and then inspect all places at home where any gamasid mites might be hiding. I wrote in detail about that to another viewer who also sent me photos of such mites, but that is a whole other story, which I will tell in one of the next videos. So subscribe to future episodes. There will be a lot of amazing stories waiting for us.